are here today to celebrate the life of Rajani Prasanna. Rajani Prasanna, née Hebbar, has lived life in full and on her terms. In the world of contemporary art, she has grappled with the abstraction by her insight and intellect. She has intuitively carved out a space to enjoy her life. Born as the youngest child to K.K. Hebbar and Sushila, she grew up in Mahim, Mumbai. Her sister Rekha and she both went to Kenosa Convent. Hebbar's house was a beehive visited by writers, painters, musicians and theatre personalities. This made her soak in culture. A lack of it and she feels like fish out of water. Rajani was a shy girl. While sister Rekha took to painting, Rajani followed her father and both sisters would enter many competitions.
Hi Rajani, Pandu and I wish you a very, very happy birthday. We wish you good health and happiness always. Rajani, I consider myself truly blessed to have known you all my life. To me, you've been a great sister, a true friend and an amazing role model. You are a strong, intelligent, kind and generous woman who found a husband to match you perfectly and raised two beautiful, wonderful children. I've looked up to you for as long as I can remember and my admiration only grows with each passing year. Happy birthday to you, dearest Rajani.
Rajani loved cats. She provided them a place to litter at her Mahim house, where she had 11 cats at one time. When they moved to Kalanagar, a bungalow and a compound allowed her to keep a dog. Successively, for 4 decades, she had a dog who was a dearest member of her family. No wonder a friend remarked, "If we were to be born again in Rajani's home, we should pray to be born as her pet."
I have fond memories of our childhood at Mahim and Kalanagar, of the mock classes that you conducted with notebooks as students and Amma's chauri pinned to the back of your short hair to give you the dignified look of a teacher. This valuable experience must surely have helped you later on during your stint at the JJ School of Art. I remember the Rakhi you used to give tie on every Raksha Bandhan day that continued unabated for over 30 to 40 years. I think you did this partly out of love and partly in the hope that I would give you that elusive Chinnarpatti sari that I kept promising both you and Rekha.
Graduating from Elphinstone College, she did her master's at Xavier's in cultural history. She took up teaching art history at the JJ School of Arts, Mumbai. Her sister Rekha played Cupid, introducing Prasanna. He was floored by this charming, bright, articulate young girl. Prasanna then marshalled his friend, Narayan Murthy, to endorse him to her. Coping with his friends was a challenge to Rajani. They enjoyed whiskey and he handed her an orange drink, which she just could not drink. When investigated by Murthy, the orange juice turned out to be Narangi, the country liquor. Their marriage was a simple celebration with friends and family at Mumbai. Next surprise by Prasanna was a budgeted honeymoon, sponsored by the cash gifts he would get as a present at the wedding. Frugal wedding, frugal honeymoon. Moran store, 3-tire train was booked for the journey. She enjoyed visiting Cubbin Park, Vidhan Saudha, Mysore Palace and the romantic Vrindavan Gardens. Rajani added Belur and Halebid to start the introduction of art and heritage to her husband. Rajani started as a lecturer in Sir J.J. School of Arts, an iconic institution for art education. Self-taught in diverse subjects like history, art and interiors, she gained a lot of respect from students and colleagues. Students, apart from observing her smart grooming, started listening to her lectures. Art show reviews in Asian Age and The Times made young artists respect her for intellect and influence over buyers. She became known as Hebbar Madam. She got ICCR grant to lecture in Europe. This deepened her knowledge of current contemporary art movements. Soon Premji allocated a budget and asked her to buy art for Wipro. She developed an intuition on who will be famous tomorrow. It took 15 years for Maharashtra government and insistence on her passing 12th standard Marathi to promote her as professor and head of art history department. She was the first in 135 years of JJ to be the woman professor and head of department. By the time she settled down in her fancy corner office, she had to make a call to live in USA or enjoy her professorship. Her students, who are big artists today, touch her feet. Let us listen to Gowde, her student.
Hello, Mrs. Prasanna. This is Usha Gowde, class of 1988. I was with Avina, and I don't think you will remember me so much. Average student, nowhere near Avina, of course. And I'd like to thank you for all the time and energy you have given us to teach us, and it's made a lot of impact in our lives.
To Milwaukee, she charmed the Wisconsin University art professor to offer Indian art history. She had to drive in bitter cold to downtown. She gained instant respect when she enrolled as a student for one semester to no student expectation in class. She enjoyed teaching, and popularity of her elective course was a testimony.
Good evening, friends. I have been associated with Rajani and family for 3 decades and counting. Today she is celebrating a historic moment in her life. What can I say about Rajani? That she is a wonderful host. She oozes charm wherever she goes. She makes one feel extremely comfortable, and she has all the warmth in the world with the people she interacts with. And once when we drove down from Milwaukee to Chicago, and on reaching Chicago, the first question she asked was, are there any art museums close by? You must know that she's a great lover of arts.
She took keen interest in adding a cultural dimension in GE. Growing GE locations soon had artworks handpicked by her. Mural by Ravi Kashi at Wipro GE, an iconic mural by Yusuf Arakul at GE Bell are priceless assets today. Annual events had a cultural richness curated by her. She introduced art, music, dance, theatre to GE Medical. Her influence as cultural ambassador extended to GE clients as well.
Hi Rajani, this is your birthday. We want to say hello to you and wish you a very good day with your loved ones. We are thinking about all those lovely days with you and class. That is a very good memory for all of us. Happy birthday!
Hello Rajani, I agree with Birgit. Congratulations on your birthday. And I also want to say, in addition to what Birgit said, that I am especially grateful for your help when it comes to picking the Indian guitar on one of my visits to India in the past. It's still in our home in Gothenburg. Thank you.
She ran an art appreciation course in CK Prahlad's executive day programs, reviewed art shows in newspapers, and was in the media for art events. Premji told her that her brand value in Bangalore is significantly higher than her husband's. Rajani activated Bangalore chapter of KK Hebbar Art Foundation, promoting upcoming artists. She taught at Design School Srishti, Chitrakala Parishad, Advertising School Vigin and Lay. Her contribution to art was recognized, and she was made member of Lalit Kala Academy. She travelled to Mysore, Dharwar, Belgaum and Chikmagalur to encourage local artists. Shireen Malani, a sharp mind in the art gallery circle, noticed the value of Rajani's opinion on contemporary art and artists, her network to old and young artists to source works, and her access to art patrons. They both partnered and set the art scene in Bangalore on fire with many interesting art events. She was recognized and honored by different forums. Let us listen to what Professor Veena has to say about Rajani.
You are the most graceful and generous person that I have ever known. In JJ especially, you were like a breath of fresh air in the arid desert that was JJ. I remember still that how we used to eagerly wait for your classes, not only to see how you dressed, the way you draped your sari and everything else, but also for the way you used to bring every artwork to life with your simple and direct explanations. You demystified art for us. You made us fall in love with art.
While Rajani was building her professional career, her work and life was well balanced. Getting Surabhi and Nihar to the right schools, particularly moving from Mumbai to USA and then to Bangalore, was challenging but yet accomplished by her. Exposing them to different cultures, soaking heritage, art history through various travel and imbibing values came easy for Rajani. It was only her husband who struggled with work and life balance.
Mom, the one thing that I wanted to share that I think the biggest influence for me growing up was that you made me believe in myself. I had some ups and downs, whether they were, you know, test scores or difficulty getting into certain classes or schools or college. You always were rooting for me, and you always cheered me on. And I think that had a very positive impact on my life, because even during the time that I doubted myself, you were always there to encourage me. And I think that because of that, I am where I am today. And it's something that I also try to instill in my children. Every time Rehan thinks that he can't do anything, I always encourage him, and I always push him as much as I can. So thank you for making me who I am today.
While Rajani single-handedly made Nihar and Surabhi achieve success in their studies and pursue in top institutions their post-graduation program, she also allowed them to be guided by their own career choices while they sought her counsel.
In high school, we had to come back to India really quickly, so I had to graduate in 3 years instead of 4. And you were the driving force in making sure that I completed all my college AP courses. When I wasn't able to understand some subjects, you hired students whom you taught at UW Madison, and they coached me through that subject, and I succeeded in graduating with honors a year earlier. You also were instrumental in convincing Dad that I should not be an engineer, but I should pursue my true passion of design. And again, when I wanted to quit my well-paying job and become an entrepreneur way before it was a buzzword, you supported me and made sure that I could follow my dreams. So there, I'm really grateful to have had that support in my life.
When it came to their choice of life partner, she was much more forthright in making them aware of the pros and cons of their choice. Then came the grandkids, and all her issues vanished. It is a pure joy for her to spend time with them.
Hi Rajani auntie, I'm traveling, so I'm sorry I can't be there, but I'd like to share one small incident that happened way back in the beginning, where I met you for the first time, and you asked me, are you sure you want to get married to my daughter? And I was like, yes. And you're like, do you know her very well? I said, well enough, I suppose. But I remember clearly you saying, see Siddharth, my daughter is a very stubborn girl. Later on, after you get married, and if you have any problem, don't come back running to me and say, why didn't you tell me about this? So I thought I'll just share this with you. Have a great time. See you soon.
When we all went together to Italy on a holiday, I liked it there. And I like eating your chaat whenever we come to visit your house. And the one thing special about both of us is that we both have our birthday on the same day.
The eldest shares her birthday and perhaps her genes. The portraits are done by her.
Rajani has a generous heart when it comes to giving her time in promoting culture, specifically art. She has identified several young students for Hebbar Scholarship. She has sponsored many a young artist in projects she's associated with. She works with her sister Rekha in art promotion through Hebbar Art Foundation. She felt that an art center should come up near Hebbar's birthplace, Kattangeri, 4 kilometers from Manipal. Rajani signed an agreement with Manipal to establish an art gallery on Manipal University. She and her sister donated 25 paintings to form the initial collection. It was inaugurated by Narayan Murthy. She persuaded her friend Zoya and cousin Narayan to add their paintings. Ranjan added 3 significant works. Today, it has become a major art happening place. She has helped many poor for access to education. An example, the Nariyal Wala.
Rajani Madam is a very old one. Rajani Madam is a very old one. She is a very old one. Scholarship is a very old one. PU pass a degree. She is a very old one.
She contributed equity when Prasanna started Manipal Akunova. After he sold Akunova, Prasanna wanted to give a third of family wealth to public health and history. She wholeheartedly supported him. Rajani's happiest moments are with her friends, particularly on trips. Her time with early life friends like Zoya in Canada, Rosetta and Bharti in Mumbai make her abandon her responsibilities and enjoy life fully. Early career trip to Sinhagad with Vidya and Vishwas is fresh in memory, and the music festival and their factory tour. NI friends like Rajagopal and Jyoti are special too, taking memorable trips with them. With 1974 friends, she has traveled the world. Rita and Arun, Annette and Sundar, Tara and Aril, Ranjit and Nina. Baithaks with Yogini and Jitu, Shukla and Debu, Bangalore Club anytime with Jayashree and Lalit are cherished memories. Her 4 friends, including Sudha, can't live without meeting her at least once a month. Rajani's life has been glorious, but the best is yet to come. Happy birthday, Rajani!